Hi and welcome back to the second video in the Flutter 101 series. So in the last video we actually installed Flutter on our system and ran Flutter Doctor to check what all dependencies we have installed, and in this video we'll be configuring Android Studio with Flutter. Okay, so now right now I don't have any idea as to how we are going to achieve it, so let's just go through the docs. So yes, we have basically installed Android Studio. We have set up an Android device. Okay, so now over here we have to configure the editor. Okay, so now when you start Android Studio, you have to open plugin preferences. Okay, so let's just close this terminal as we don't need it right now. Okay, so now let's launch Android Studio. Okay, if you don't have Android Studio installed on your system, I have a tutorial which addresses it, and I will be making another tutorial to actually explain how to install Android Studio on Linux, because it is somewhat tedious process, as you need to export the whole thing to a different folder and then use the _studio package in the bin directory, and then you can launch Android Studio. But after all, you can very well use it from your desktop as a normal application. Okay, so now over here we have to go into preferences and plugin. Okay, so this is over here, we have plugins. Okay, and inside plugins we need to click on browse repository. Okay, so we are in browse repository, and over here we need to install Flutter. Okay, so yes. So when I have clicked on install for Flutter, it is also prompting me to install Dart, which is the programming language. So we have to click yes over here, and yes, now it will basically download everything, and now we need to restart Android Studio, and in the meantime let's again run Flutter Doctor and let's see if we have resolved that message of not having Dart installed. Okay, so let's first get into, or we don't need it right now because we have already set our path variable. Okay, so right now it cannot find the command Flutter, because over here if you have watched the last video, we have actually copy pasted this particular command, which and over here it is also written that the above command sets your path variable temporarily for the current terminal window. To permanently add Flutter to your path, see update your path. Okay, so in some future video we will be adding Flutter permanently to our path, because we don't actually need the Flutter command line interface except for Flutter Doctor. So for now we can definitely use this particular command, but over here the command is pwd, so it is present working directory, and for that I need to be present in the directory where Flutter is actually installed. Okay, so let's first go over there. So I have Flutter in tools, and over here now I can use this command. Okay, so be sure to not copy this dollar sign, because that is actually the sign of the bash terminal. Okay, so now we can run Flutter Doctor. Okay, yes, so we need to wait for some time till this happen, and we should at least not see the error of not having Flutter installed. Okay, so yes, now we are again seeing the error, Flutter plugin not installed. Okay, so I guess now, okay, let's click OK. Okay, let's restart. So I guess now Android Studio will write some particular file, and then we can maybe see the Flutter domain. Okay, so yes, let's wait for it to load. Okay, so now over here you can see a new option which says start a new Flutter project. Okay, so now the Flutter plugin has been perfectly installed. So now let's again run Flutter Doctor. Okay, and the reason it was saying that Flutter plugin not installed in spite of we having it installed is because until you click on OK, there is some configuration file somewhere which actually stores a value called if flutter variable or flutter installed, and it is set to false at first. Okay, and then when you have Flutter installed, it is then set to true. Okay, so you have some sort of configuration going on, so that is why restarting of Android Studio was important, and we are now seeing the difference over here. Okay, so yes, Android Studio is good and we don't have this error now, Flutter plugin not installed and Dart plugin not installed. So yes, now we have this error called some Android licenses not accepted. To resolve this, run Flutter Doctor. Okay, so let's just run this command. Okay, so I guess what this does is that it will download some files. Okay, it didn't wait for my review. Okay, it was asking for a yes or no option over here. So it didn't wait for my review. Okay. So yes, I do accept it. Yes. Again, yes, yes. Okay, so yes, now we have all licenses accepted, and let's run Flutter Doctor again. Okay, so first of all, you can ignore this error because it is just telling us that we don't have some file installed, or we can also go and install it. It is just a sudo apt-get install command. So yes, let's even do it so that we start with a clean slate having no errors. So yes, now I enter my password over here. Because I am in sudo mode, I need to enter my password. So sudo is basically giving you the super user access. Okay, so once you have this installed, let's again run Flutter Doctor. And if you have not watched my previous video, please click on the link in the description below and go and watch that episode, because that is when I actually talk about the importance of why you need to learn Flutter or any other cross-platform development language or skills, or Dart in this case. Okay, so yes, by now we have got all the errors sorted and we don't have a connected device over here because we don't have any mobile device connected right now. So in the next episode, we will be setting up a sample project in Android Studio and we will be launching the emulator. We have the Android emulator over here. I am not working on a Mac right now, so we don't have the iOS simulator over here, but as we progress ahead, I will be migrating the whole project to a Mac, and then we can also launch the iOS simulator and to see the difference between our codes. But in order to get started to learn the very basics, I guess even Android display is the same, and you can pretty much be assured that what you see on Android is something which will be similar on the iOS screen but with some customization flavor, which is of the native iOS style. Okay, so yes, I guess that's it for this video, and if you have just stumbled across this channel, feel free to share and subscribe, because I am exploring this new idea of learning things together, and I will have some IO 18 Flutter videos linked in the description below, so feel free to go and watch them as it can be a great source of knowledge. And yes, so thanks for watching and see you next time.